Oh, bouncer first ball. Surprised Brian Lara. Didn't expect it. Doesn't normally happen with Indian bowlers. They like to loosen up, warm up.
And it was a good bouncer as well, directly towards the batsman. That's what you want to be doing, getting the batsman to have to do something, either play and defend it down onto the ground or ducking. Did well there, Lara.
Playing and missing. It's a good over, 131 for two. He's hooked him. Short, gave him ample time. He's a very good puller of the ball, Carl Hooper is. The first boundary of the day.
Been bowling a lot of short balls this morning, Zahir Khan. That didn't bounce a great deal though. He got them up quite a lot higher when he bowled them at Brian Lara. Only good thing about that is was going in the right direction, away from Carl Hooper, to make it just a touch more difficult, but it wasn't high enough to bother him.
Nicely played, very nicely played. Won't get a boundary. The outfield slows down over here. The soaking it has taken over the years, over the days, and then the last couple of days does slow the ball down as it comes towards the advertising boards. That's the end of the over. 141 for two. Good delivery, that. Very good delivery. You can see Lara's nervousness as well, because he's also playing at deliveries that he should be leaving alone. That's a good angle, Michael.
Very good angle. I think that was an excellent delivery. Weird pitch he had to play. He wasn't too sure if it was going to continue on that line through to the wicketkeeper or straighten fractionally.
That is bad. Very good effort that by Harbhajan Singh. He has got a dodgy shoulder. It's very good running by the West Indians. They've taken three.
Good cricket all around, that, except for the bowling, of course. Slightly wrong line, that, from Jawagal Srinath, but that was very good running to get three runs down the fine leg. Had a lot of ground to cover. Harbhajan Singh did it well, and we know that he has been having a few problems with that shoulder of his, so he was unable to throw it. Oh, that could have been a bit uncomfortable, rolling over on that left hand like that. Well appreciated by his teammates.
No ball signal, punched down the ground by Lara. It won't reach the boundary. Just pulling up inside. Three comfortable runs. Four runs added to the score because of that signal. See from Lara is that his footwork has been positive even when he came into bat yesterday. Shot, and again pulled away. He's not in control of it, just out of the reach of Shivsundar Das in front of the umpire. I think he was just a little late in picking it. 152 for two. This is the last ball of the previous over. Hooper looking to drag it from outside the off stump. And Shivsundar Das just unable to reach it. Just got a feeling when you're in a situation like this, you've got to get a little more desperate. I think the dive should have come out there. Starts off with a full toss and loosener, and bang down the ground by Hooper.
That's exactly what I was talking about earlier. You just cannot bowl such sloppy deliveries as that. You know the game is tight. You've got to bowl the length. And there's no excuse for that. That's miles overpitched, is that? I mean, if you can't run up at this level and bowl six balls roughly in the area you want, you shouldn't be playing.
It's been taken. Nehra has struck. The big wicket of Lara. And just like in the first innings, he was out caught behind. It's a very similar shot. He can't believe what he's done. But India have got the big wicket.
Well, we're just saying about change the bowling. Change the bowling. Fourth ball is bowled. Second ball at Rara. And that's the difference. You just change the bowling. You give the batsman something else to think about. Different action. It's a beautiful delivery. Maybe a touch wide, but that's being hypercritical. It's just a lovely length, you see. Look at the length, plays, and it just bounces. Maybe he could have left it, but you see, got used to Zahir Khan, new bowler. You just don't quite pick up the different line. And it's not, and it isn't the, just because they both bowl left hand, they don't have the same actions. One's a skidder, this kid's a skidder. Zahir's a banger in 157 for.
Here's how Lara went, not dissimilar to the way he went in the first innings. Just fishing at it outside the off stump, ball leaving him, a little bit of extra bounce, and straight into the safe hands of Rahul Dravid. Thick edge.
Well, Sourav Ganguly excited, why not? He's got the wicket of Brian Lara.
Hooper has gone over the top. Oh, it's a typical Hooper shot, got under it. Hoisted it, good, confident blow by Hooper for four.
And that's good thinking by the West Indian captain, because he knows that Shivnarayan Chandrakul, who's just coming to bat, can at best at the other end nudge and push the singles, unlike Brian Lara, who could hit the boundary. So he needs to score the runs, Carl Hooper. And that's what he's trying to do. He's hit it with the turn very safely. There's no protection there for Harbhajan Singh. It's a safe shot, very good shot.
Hooper has hit it straight into the hands of mid-wicket. Two big wickets for India. And they know now that they're in a very, very good position. They've got rid of Lara in Nehra's previous over. They've now got rid of Hooper. And the West Indies are 164 for four. And India have seized the initiative.
Well, I'm not too sure this was the right kind of shot to play, because the ball was angled from left hand over the wicket. Hooper just wasn't in any position to play that. Wasn't able to hit it along the ground. There it is, angled. There it is, around his waist. Didn't quite come up there. But straight to Shiv Sundar Das. And Ganguly, boy, is he excited. The two danger men, he knows, are back in the pavilion. 164 for four.